Hey guys, welcome to another exciting topic, Antiparkinsonian Drugs. We will study this topic over 3 videos. In this first video, we will see relevant pathophysiology of Parkinson's disease and classification of Antiparkinsonian Drugs. In second and third video, we will see each class in detail. And fourth video, if we create, will be revision of entire topic. Are you ready for the ride? Let's start with pathophysiology. This is a brain. If you take its coronal section, it will look something like this. Here we want to focus on structures of basal ganglia. It has coated nucleus and putamen. Together they comprise corpus striatum. Then we have globus pallidus and substantia nigra in midbrain. Now some neurons from substantia nigra pars compacta goes to corpus striatum. They are called nigrostriatal pathway. These neurons are dopaminergic. Let's see neurotransmission by dopamine here. This is presynaptic terminal of neuron coming from substantia nigra. This is postsynaptic terminal of neuron of basal ganglia. And of course, this is synaptic cleft. Now, precursor of dopamine in our body is amino acid tyrosine. It is taken up by nerve terminal. In cytoplasm, it is first acted upon by hydroxylase. It carries out hydroxylation of tyrosine and converts it into dopa. Then the dopa is acted upon by another enzyme, decarboxylase. As per its name, it causes decarboxylation of dopa and thus converts it into dopamine. The dopamine molecules thus synthesized are transported into secretory vesicles. Here they are stored. Then when the impulse comes, they are released into the synaptic cleft. Postsynaptic neurons have dopamine receptors where dopamine binds. And thus we get dopamine activity in basal ganglia. From the cleft, most of the dopamine is taken back in presynaptic neurons. And most of that dopamine is again transported into the secretory vesicle for reuse. Some dopamine is degraded. There are two enzymes for this. First one is monoamine oxidase or MAO, especially MAO-B. It is present on the membrane of mitochondria. It inactivates dopamine present in cytoplasm. The other enzyme is catechol-O-methyltransferase or COMT. The dopamine in synaptic cleft is inactivated by this enzyme. In either case, the other enzyme also act on these metabolites and finally produce homovanillic acid. The dopamine thus lost is replaced by synthesis of new dopamine. So this is neurotransmission by dopamine. Let's quickly see dopamine receptors also. Dopamine receptors are of 5 types, D1 to D5. They all are G protein coupled receptors. D1 and D5 are excitatory type and D2, 3 and 4 are inhibitory type. Now apart from these dopaminergic neurons, there are also cholinergic neurons which produce cholinergic activity. So this was neurotransmission. Postsynaptic neurons in turn connect with thalamus and motor cortex. Dopamine activity on these neurons is essential for carrying out body movements. This was physiology. Now pathology. In Parkinson's disease, neurons of nigrostriatal pathway degenerates. So dopamine activity is reduced. This results in various movement problems like hypokinesia, rigidity and tremors. We don't know exactly how and why these neurons undergo degeneration, but there are various theories. One theory that I want to mention says, metabolite of dopamine produces free radicals which cause damage to the nerve. Drugs that block dopamine receptors, for example, antipsychotic drugs and antiemetic drugs like prochlorperazine and metoclopramide can also cause Parkinson's-like disease. So this is the basic that you must know. Now let's see the anti-Parkinsonian drugs. Remember, till date we have no drug that can reverse or even stop the degeneration of neurons in nigrostriatal pathway. All the drugs that we have merely support the remaining neurons to compensate for lost neurons. And second thing, although we want to increase dopamine activity in basal ganglia, we cannot give dopamine itself because it cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. So which drugs we have? Let's see. In this figure, this side is brain and these are peripheral tissues. This wall in between represents blood-brain barrier. Now the first anti-Parkinsonian drug is levodopa. It is a precursor of dopamine. After a long journey in peripheral tissues, it enters into the brain. With this extra supply of precursor, remaining healthy neurons can easily synthesize more dopamine. So more dopamine works on postsynaptic neurons, which restores dopamine activity. So the patient gets symptomatic relief. Now the difficulty with levodopa is most of it is degenerated in peripheral tissues. This mainly occurs by dopa decarboxylase. And some amount is also degraded by COMT. Its degeneration limits the amount that can enter into the brain. To handle this, we have two groups of drug here. One is peripheral dopa decarboxylase inhibitors and the other is COMT inhibitors. They prevent degradation of dopa in peripheral tissue so that more can enter into the brain and work. Now let's go further down the road. We know that dopamine acts on dopamine receptors. Then it is taken back by presynaptic neurons. From here, either it is transported into the vesicle for reuse or undergo degradation by MAO-B. We have few more groups working in this area. First one is amantadine. It increases synthesis as well as release of dopamine and also inhibits its uptake. So more dopamine is there in synaptic cleft to stimulate postsynaptic neurons. Next we have dopamine agonists. They stimulate dopamine receptors directly. Then we have MAO-B inhibitors. They inhibit degradation of dopamine so that neurons can have more dopamine to work. Finally, centrally acting anti-muscarinic agents. Although the problem is not with cholinergic neurons, lack of dopaminergic activity causes relative increase in cholinergic activity. So inhibiting these receptors also provides some symptomatic relief. So these are all the classes of anti-Parkinsonian drugs. We will study them one by one in detail from next video. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues so that they can also have clear understanding on anti-Parkinsonian drugs. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.